Welcome to The Fifth Estate, a conversation between young African scholars from the Fort Hall School of Government and Professor Mutahi Ngunyi. Today, we will send a letter to the House of Gemma, and in the name of Yokoyo and Mobi, we will address them facing Mount Kenya. Dear people of Gemma, William Ruto had convinced you to reject what is good for country and what is good for Gemma. And you'd been convinced that BBI is bad because it was not good. Or were you? Dear House of Mobi, I want to put it to you that you were just fooling around with Ruto. And I say so because your Mau Mau heroes taught you that all politics is based on deception. They taught you that there is no point going to battle over a war you can win using deception. Bravo, people of Gemma, for lying to Ruto so professionally. No, bravo for driving the point home painfully. Out of 550 Gemma MCAs, only 4 voted for Ruto in the BBI vote. This is an equivalent of 0.7% of Gemma. Very painful indeed. And very shameful for Ruto and his bravado.
Dear Gemma Nation, we write to you to congratulate you for using Ruto and dumping him. Your church leaders have eaten from him every Sunday, and your youth are still receiving M-Pesa from him. We congratulate you for twisting his logic. When he told you to lipa deni, you cleverly told him to lipa rent. And using deception, you borrowed the face of church leaders to collect rent, thinking he was buying you. Then you rewarded him with 4 votes out of 540 votes this week. Bravo, Kikuyus. But your deception did not end there. Ruto brought you wheelbarrows, and then you chanted, Ruto, Ruto. You embraced and kissed the wheelbarrow because it was a symbol of hard work. But you were lying to him. You knew that between the wheelbarrow and Uhuru Kenyatta pumping 7 billion shillings every month into Gemma communities through BBI, the wheelbarrow was a sheer joke. In your mind, you thought that the wheelbarrow was a primitive idea. But you did not tell Ruto. In fact, you thought that Ruto was primitive. But you did not say a word. Instead, you continued collecting rent from him. Bravo for the deceit.
Dear House of Gemma, Uhuru Kenyatta has proposed to increase revenue allocation to Gemma by almost 80 billion. And so I ask, what is wrong with that? Between the man who doubles your revenue and the one who tells you to reject the money, who is your enemy? The story of Uhuru Kenyatta and William Ruto can only be explained by George Orwell's fable, Animal Farm. It is about a leader with a plan and a detractor executing a scheme. Once upon a time, a leader called Snowball had completed the plans to build a windmill. He had drawn them on a huge piece of paper, which he laid on the floor. All the animals came down to look at the drawings to be inspired. But a pig called Napoleon stayed away. Like Ruto, he hated the BBI windmill, but did not say why. Then one day, he arrived without giving notice. He lifted his left leg and urinated over all the plants, destroying them. And this is Ruto for you. He has urinated on all the president's plants without giving alternatives. And so I ask, is he a friend or an enemy?
Dear Gemma people, who deceived whom? did you deceive William Ruto, or did Ruto deceive you? Who brought William Ruto to you after ICC accused him of killing Kikuyus in 2007? Was it not Uhuru Kenyatta? Is he not the person who convinced you that you were safe with Ruto? Is it not true that without Uhuru, Ruto would still be an enemy of Gemma? But once Ruto cuddled in the warmth of Uhuru's hospitality, and Gemma had kissed a man who ICC had accused of killing Kikuyus, Ruto changed. In the shadows of Gemma, Ruto became a green snake in the grass. He exploited the absence of Uhuru Kenyatta in a very deceitful way. He began to poison the hearts and minds of Gemma. He told Gemma that Uhuru had abandoned them and did not care. And in the darkness of COVID, he gave donations to churches and told them that Uhuru was a traitor. Then he gave wheelbarrows to Kikuyu earthlings and told them that this was the revolution. But who is fooling whom? Between Uhuru's $80 billion a year to Gemma through BBI and Ruto's wheelbarrows, where is the revolution? Kikuyus are not stupid.
Dear Gemma Nation, you have inflicted injury on William Ruto by giving him only 4 votes out of 550 votes. And you have done this after eating his money and airtime for 2 years. As Niccolo Machiavelli taught us, if you injure a generous opponent like Ruto, your injury must be so severe that you must not fear his revenge. Gemma cannot cross the BBI river and constantly going back to the banks to rest. If Gemma has crushed the BBI enemies, the crush must be total. A viper half dead will only recover and generate more poison towards you. If Ruto recovers from the injury Gemma has caused him, he will sting Kikuyus in ways they have never seen. Even Moses in the Holy Bible was instructed to destroy his enemies completely. Elohim, the Almighty, instructed him to make no covenants with his opponents and to show no mercy to his enemies, because they will show him none. If Gemma has shown Ruto no mercy with this BBI vote, Ruto will show them no mercy if they embrace him after betraying him.
And now a random thought. Dear Kikuyus, one day, a Gemma priest who had received sadaka from Ruto died of COVID. When he arrived in heaven, he asked whether heaven was the Hustler Nation. St. Peter was confused because intelligence had not told them that there was a Hustler Nation. Baffled by this information, he ordered the Gemma pastor to spend one day in hell and one day in heaven to determine which was the Hustler Nation. The Gemma pastor was put on a lift and lowered into hell. When the lift opened, he was astonished. Hell was actually beautiful. It had beautiful homes, big cars, free booze, and happiness galore. Everything Ruto said about the Hustler Nation was there. Then, the next day, the Gemma pastor was taken to heaven. God and the clouds were actually very boring. And there was no M-Pesa in heaven. God told him he was the M-Pesa. With this experience, the Gemma pastor was asked to vote between hell and heaven. And he voted for hell. Then he was put back in the lift and lowered back to hell. When the doors opened, the Gemma pastor was shocked. Hell had changed. It was dark, dirty, smell, and nasty. When he asked what had happened, William Ruto replied, Dear Kikuyus, yesterday I was campaigning. Today you voted, and that is the difference.